Melody Salesforce Flowsome.
Hello, Flowsome people. Welcome to the Salesforce Flowsome channel. In this video, we will explain what are variables and collections. The biggest difference when switching from workflow and process builder to flow is that we need to handle the variables ourselves. If you don't have any programming background, variables might sound a bit intimidating, but I'm sure that you have definitely worked with variables before and should be quite familiar with it. Have you seen this type of equation before? X here is the best example of a variable. By definition, a variable is something that will change. Easy, right? Then why do we need variable? It is because there is a specific process we want to go through, but we don't know some details yet. So we create a placeholder for the details and we'll fill them in afterwards. That's right, a variable is exactly like a placeholder. For example, if I want to buy several apples that will cost $2 each and a $1 bag, I don't know how many apples to buy yet, so I use X as a placeholder. Then no matter how many I buy, I know I will pay for 2x plus $1 at the end. Then depending on the scenarios, you will have different types of variables too. The X here is a number type variable. For another example, if you are writing the Christmas cards with the same content to your family, the Y here is a text type variable. Then things become interesting when looking at the record type variable. So if we look at this process to update an account, we want to update the name and the rating for account Z. We don't know which account it is yet, but we know that there will be a name field and a rating field, and the values are dependent on which account it is. I call this a variable of variables. A very important concept about record variable is that they don't connect to your actual records. When you store a record into a variable, you copy the values into this variable. Then they don't have any links to the original record anymore. You can modify this variable freely and it won't affect the actual record unless you tell the system to do so. When you ask the system to update the records, you provide this variable and the system will check the ID stored in that variable, find a match in your database, and then update the matched record with your variable. Because the variable and the record are not synced, if you change the ID to account B and ask the system to update again, this time the account B will be matched and updated with field values from Z. You can also clean up the ID and ask the system to create the record. Then you're cloning the original record and the ID will be written back to the variable. Also, you don't even need to copy a record into a variable for it to work. You can simply enter the ID and other fields manually, and then the system will be able to update the record by the matched ID. Finally, the collection is just a list of variables. It can be a list of numbers, a list of texts, or a list of records. You just need to check that allow multiple values to create a collection. That's it for variables and collections. If you enjoyed this video, like, subscribe, and turn on notification. Salesforce Flowsome, thank you for watching.